Okay, Mike Masato, CEO of Staff Driven Dental, and the Dental Road Warrior, returning for episode 68 in the series. So a little chat today. I'm on the road here talking about power. And I use the word power a lot, and I noticed going back on some of the titles of the episodes and using the word power on different subjects. But what is power? And the reason why I want to talk about this is because so many times I meet doctors and that I'm coaching for the first time. And I mean, they're very talented and able individuals in many areas of what they do. There's no doubt about that. And they've created a lot of great things in practice, a lot of great things in life. But why are they struggling? And it's because they don't understand the concept of power, what it means to be in power in your practice. And this is a vital, important aspect of leadership in life, for that matter, to be able to be in a power position and hold that position and power in your practice. And a lot of times, the doctors that I see, just because of the way they operate over a course of a day, it's really diluting their power and making them weak and not strong in certain areas, and it's affecting the practice. So, you know, there are different aspects of power. You know, part of power is being focused and being able to do what you're doing when you're doing it. Very simple. I mean, you wouldn't think about that, but let's take that concept for a minute. Just going into your practice every day, doc, and being able to do what you're doing when you're doing it. You know, you try this, you know, how many days have you had when you go into your practice and you're trying to work on patients and you're in there with the patient, but your mind is someplace else? You're distracted, you're thinking about something else, or you're getting pulled away from what you're doing left and right. You feel like you're getting bounced all over the practice because things are running chaotically and you're getting pulled in different directions by the staff, you know, or there's a problem over here, you're putting out a fire over there, and you're dispersed and all over. You're never going to be powerful, number one, if you can't be doing what you're doing when you're doing it. In other words, when you're doing dentistry, you're in your room laser focused on doing dentistry. There's a reason why they call the term laser focused, because when you take the light of a laser and you super concentrate it, it's very powerful. It'll burn a hole right through you, all right? But when its light is dispersed all over the place, it can be harmless and do nothing. So again, the more focused and laser focused you are, and more not dispersed and not all over the place, and being focused on just one thing when you're doing it, the more powerful you are. And there's so many aspects of that go on every step of the way, every throughout the course of the day, not just doing dentistry. But let's say if you do paperwork, or let's say you're doing closing a case and working on closing a case with a patient, that you can't be possibly be effective if, like, you know, the way the scheduling is, you know, you're trying to focus on a patient and, you know, in the back of your mind, there's 2, 3, 4, 5 people waiting for you out there, you know, and you're supposed to be there and really focus on, you know, meeting a new patient for the first time, or trying to close a case, or trying to make money, you know, for the practice. You know, there's many areas that I see this. We're not focused on time. We're kind of all over the place when it comes to our time, you know, and that, and again, this also takes away our power. So again, one of the things is just be able to be whatever you're doing, to be doing that at the time you're doing it. That in itself is power. Being able to hold your position in the practice and not being knocked all over the place and not being, you know, weak when it comes to, you know, adversity or resistance that comes up in the practice. That's powerful also too. The people that can, the doctors that can consistently, you know, hold their position in practice and not feel like the practice is running them, or the staff is running them and the patients are running them every day, right? Being at effect of your practice every day instead of causing it. You know, that's powerful to be able to do that. Like, you know, I'm in charge. I'm going to make it go my way. I'm going to make it go right no matter what in this practice, right? And that's what I'm going to do. And nothing's going to knock me off that perch. It's like the old game we played as kids, King of the Mountain. What made you powerful? Because you could stand on top of that mountain and no one could knock you off, and you hold your position. That made you powerful. It's kind of the same thing in your practice. But we often don't want to look at ourselves as leaders in our practice. We wanted to put it on somebody else. That's true. Having an office manager is very important. But guess what? That office manager is your second in command. Now, she's there to support you and take direction and guidance and leadership from you. So if you're weak as a leader and kind of all over the place, and she's like, doc, look over here. I'm trying to get you to do this. Focus on this. What are you putting your attention on every day? Okay? And a lot of times these managers are trying to have the docs like, look, here, what they're trying to do is have you be more powerful by being focused on one thing at a time. And that's kind of challenging, staff. I know some of you that are watching staff, they get a doctor to really just be focused on one thing and not all over the place. You know? Also, another thing that makes you powerful is the speed at which you get things done. You know, the speed at which things move in a practice is power. You know, things are just clicking like left and right in the practice and moving quickly. Now, a lot of times, you know, we do crazy things with time. You know, we're sitting in our office, you know, and we know there's patients here, but I got time. You know, I'm going to be on my computer and I'm going to be doing this and I'm going to be doing that. You know, I mean, I've seen this manifest itself in so many ways. Younger doctors, it's games. They're playing video games online. You know, older doctors, stock, they're watching their stocks. I got to check my stocks today. I'm not kidding. I can't make this stuff up. I actually saw a doctor one time many years ago. I think it might have been in Manhattan in the financial district, but it was someplace like that. And he had a stock ticker. You know, those red light, you know, LED lights that going across the stock ticker. And it ran through every one of his treatment rooms because he was big into the market. So he would be looking up, he'd be working on patients, and all he'd be doing is checking his stocks, looking at the stock ticker, running through all his treatment rooms. And that's nuts. Okay? I mean, I wouldn't believe it unless I saw it myself. But how powerful are you being if you have one eye on the stocks and the stock market and one eye on your patient? Not very powerful. You know, this stuff is very distracting in our practice. And that takes away our focus and our power. Right, but the way we keep things moving in a practice, and you should be insisting on this, doc, in your practice, that you keep things moving and clicking. Of course, scheduling is part of that. And if you ever notice when things start slowing down the schedule because we're backed up or we have holes in the schedule, things aren't scheduled properly, you know, people don't know what they're doing because they're not trained properly and everything is slowed down and you have to intervene on everything all the time, you know, this slows the whole operation down. Now think of the RPMs of an engine, the RPMs a car puts out. And the more RPMs the engine can put out, the more powerful it is. So if it's turbocharged, it's a lot more powerful than if you got a four-cylinder, a small little car. All right. So again, the more power you have, the more things move, how fast they move, how rapidly they move in the practice, the more powerful we are. You know, and you want to keep things moving that way. That's also power. Right? So there are many aspects of power. Because we don't understand what they are, don't want to look at them, you know, that we, you know, dilute our power and we're kind of all over that, all over the place in our practice. And a lot of times what I do when I coach doctors is like, doc, what are you putting your attention on? What are you looking at? What are you looking at? What's distracting you, you know, over the course of the day here? Because when you're doing that, you know, and you're being that way, and I talk about who you're being, about what you're doing, being focused and being, laser intention, you know, it goes a long way in the practice to being powerful and generating the kind of revenue you want in your practice and having things go the way you want it to go. You know? But again, a lot of times, we forget that as doctors, we just can't walk in the door and flip a switch and go through the day and I'm just going to do my dentistry. There's more to it than that. And you have to put attention and realize, you know, how you are throughout the course of a day as a leader. How weak or powerful you are determines how the day goes and how much money you're going to make. Now, how successful you're going to be, right? So again, there are other elements, I'm sure. I could talk about power for a long time, but I wanted to give you, just something I wanted to talk about because I've been seeing a lot of this lately with dentists and really diffusing their power by the way they operate during the course of a day, right? So I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you are, please share them. I'm always open to topics. You can send them to me as well, too. And I'll be back with another episode soon.